world leaders have been attending the Munich Security Conference this weekend, with the conflict in Gaza high on the agenda. Our editor-at-large, Yusuf Aram, is there. He's spoken with Salman Sheikh, the founder and CEO of the Sheikh Group, a non-profit mediation organisation, and asked him if the 7th of the October attacks were on Israel were the starting point or a continuation of the conflict.
I first went to Gaza in 2000, just before the start of the Second Intifada. So no, 2000, what happened right now on October the 7th did not happen in a vacuum. What we've seen progressively, though, is that those who have been resisting the Israeli occupation have become more and more sophisticated. Now, what happened on October the 7th by Hamas and other Palestinian groups from Gaza was horrendous. And I think it was almost, maybe it got a little bit out of control, even for their liking. But what they were attempting to do was to break the status quo, to break the orthodoxies that somehow Israel could build very high walls, use technology as well as its army to completely shut themselves off from the Palestinian frustration which was seething behind those walls.
What was Hamas's objectives October 7th, and have they achieved those goals?
I believe they already have, yes. Their objective was, as I said, is simply to break the status quo, to show Israeli leadership and society that they could not be forever held back in the current conditions. There's been a bonus for them that it's been now 4 months, and they still have not been militarily defeated, as was the goal that Prime Minister Netanyahu set for these military operations. And furthermore, we've had more than 30,000 people probably who have been killed. According to the UN figures, 100,000 that have been killed or injured, which has created, I believe, very big damage in terms of Israel's standing in the international community.